Last class we left our discussion in the how do we construct the image for an object which is placed on the principal axis. So in that we discussed the first point. So now let us discuss the second point. So now what you have to do is you have to draw another line or another ray of line that is coming from A, and that should passes the first focal point. And this ray which is passing from the first principal focus F1 and touching the first principal plane K1 will emerges out from K2. So K2 will be on the second principal plane, and from that K2 the incident light ray will gets emerged out, such that that ray of light will be parallel to the principal axis. So whenever a ray of light passes from focal point, it emerges as a parallel ray to the principal axis, and whenever there is an incident ray which is parallel to the principal axis, then that ray emerges out from the focal point. So now we are supposed to draw the line which passes from the principal focal point F1. So this is the second ray. This ray crosses the first principal plane at K1. So this point you can denote as K1. So from this, if you draw the parallel line, so from this point, that is from K2, the incident ray will get emerged out. So this is the emerged ray for the second incident ray. Now what happened here? A ray which came from A passed through the first focal point and crossed the principal axis at K1, and this ray got emerged out from the point K2. So now from the diagram, K2 P2 is equals to K1 P1. Why? Because this line is parallel to the principal axis, then this distance will be equals to this distance. So in second line we understood K1 P1 is equals to K2 P2. Again I am telling, if you write the points like the way I have written here, then you will not get the marks. You have to write the statement for how do you construct the image. So in that, for the second ray of light, how this second ray is incident and at what point it has incident and what point it crosses and how this ray will gets emerged out. Only after that, only after writing that statement, you have to write this K1 P1 is equals to K2 P2. So now let us draw the third ray of light, that is AT1 N1. So like the way we drawn in the last part or in the last section, so there's another ray which passes from the point T1. So this point is on the first principal plane. So now let me draw the line. So this point here is T1, and this ray of light will get emerged out from the point T2, which is present on the second principal plane H2. So T1 is present on the H1 plane and T2 is present on the H2 plane. So this incident ray will get emerged out from T2. Passing from the point or passing from the nodal point N2. So incident ray AT1 N1 emerges out as T2 N2 and A prime. So now you can draw the image here. So this point of intersection here will give the image of the object AB. So this is A prime, B prime. So A prime, B prime is the image of the object AB. So this image is formed by the intersection of all the refracted ray that came from the object AB. So here A prime B prime will be the image of an object AB. A prime B prime is the image of an object AB. So AB is object, A prime B prime is image. So we got this image by some rules, or the rules which are made to how the incident rays and emergent rays will cross the optical system and forms the image. So this we learned, there are basically three points in the concept of the construction image or construction of image in the optical system. So you have to learn all these three points, then you can easily draw the image of an object that is placed on the principal axis. So distance from B to F1 is x1, and distance from F1 to P1, so from here to here, it is F1, and distance from P2 to F2 is what, F2, so here, and from F2 to B prime, it is X2. So the distance B1 F1 is X1, F1 B1 is F1, and P2 F2 is F2, and F2 B prime is X2. So with this knowledge, let us derive the Newton's formula. So to derive the formula, now let us first consider two similar triangles AB F1 and F1 B1 K1. So consider two similar triangles which are they AB F1 and F1 K1 P1. So from the diagram we can write K1 P1 divided by AB AB. So now this distance K1 P1 is equals to A prime B prime, but this distance K1 P1 is not equals to AB. So we can write K1 P1 by AB is equals to P1 F1 divided by B F1. So if you take these two triangles as similar triangles, then you can write P1 F1 is equals to F1 B1 and P1 K1 is equals to, or P1 K1 by AB. So this we wrote by considering these two triangles as similar triangles, but we know that K1 P1 is equals to A prime B prime. So K1 P1 can be replaced with A prime B prime and this AB as it is. So from diagram P1 F1 is what? P1 F1 is F1 and F1 B is X1. So substitute here F1 divided by X1. Now consider another similar triangles A prime B prime F2 and H2 P2 F2. So A prime B prime F2 and H2 P2 F2. So that is here H2 P2 F2. So let these two triangles be the similar triangles. Now, A prime B prime divided by H2 P2, which is equals to B prime F2, and that is equals to P2 F2. So, but from the diagram we know H2 P2 is equals to AB. So, if I substitute that, A prime B prime divided by AB is equals to B prime F2 is X2. B prime F2 is X2. P2 F2 is F2. So we got X2 by F2 for A prime B prime divided by AB, and for in the first case we got A prime B prime divided by AB as F1 and X1. So now if you equate these two equations, let's suppose this equation be equation number 1 and this is equation 2. If you equate these two equations from 1 and 2, what you can write, F1 by X1 is equals to X2 by F2. So let this equation be equation number 3, and if you cross multiply, then what will happen? F1 multiplied by F2 is equals to X1 multiplied by X2. So this equation represents the Newton's formula. So from the diagram, from this diagram, we can write P1B is equals to H1A. These two distances are equal, and this H1A and P1B actually gives us the object distance that is denoted by U. And now this U will take negative because we are measuring it in the opposite direction. So now we have the object distance. Now let us calculate the image distance. So image distance will be what? P2B prime, which is equals to K2A prime. So this gives you the image and object distance. So now AB is what? Is the height of the object. So now this AB is equals to H1 P1 and H2 P2. So AB can be written as P1 H1, and this is again equals to P2 H2. So that is clear from the diagram. So AB distance is equals to P1 H1 and P2 H2. So this, let us take this as H1. So now you have the height of the object. So now let us find the height of the image. So let us denote height of the image as H2. So H2 is equals to A prime B prime. Obviously A prime B prime will give the height of the image, and this A prime B prime is equals to K1 P1 and K2 P2. So from the diagram you have the object distance, the image distance, the height of the object and the height of the image. Since the image is in the opposite direction to the object direction, so we have to take this as negative. So this is pointing away from the principal axis, or in the negative y axis. So this is in the positive y-axis and this is in the negative axis. So therefore we take h2 as minus and h1 as plus. h1 gives the object distance and h2 gives the image distance. Now let me write k1 h1. So this k1 h1 is equals to k1 p1 plus p1 h1. Which is equals to what? K1 P1 plus P1 H1. So from the above data we can say K1 P1 as minus H2 and P1 H1 as H1. So K1 P1 is minus H2 plus P1 H1 as H1. So this overall distance from H1 to K1 can be written as minus H2 plus H1. So K1 H1 is minus H2 plus 1 plus H1. So let us write what can be the K2 H2. So K2 H2 is equals to, so this will be equals to what? K2 P2 plus P2 H2. K2 P2 plus P2 H2. So you have K1 H1 and now we are finding what is K2 H2. So from this here, K2 P2 is minus H2. Plus P2 H2 is H1. So both the distances, that is K1 to H1 and K2 to H2, has got the value minus H2 plus H1 and minus H2 plus H1. So now let us consider the similar triangles. K1 F1 P1 and K1 AH1. So which are those? K1 F1 P1 and KAH1. K A and H1. So we have considered the two similar triangles, K1 F1 P1 and K1 AH1. So these two triangles are similar triangles. So from the laws of similar triangles, we can write P1 F1 divided by H1 A1 is equals to P1 P1 K1 P1 divided by K1 H1. I have written here P1 F1. So this distance P1 F1 divided by H1 A1. And that is equals to K1 P1 which is divided by K1 H1. So is this clear? So this F1 P1 divided by AH1 and K1 P1 is divided by K1 H1. So that is what we have written here. P1 F1 divided by H1 A. So we know P1 F1 as minus F1 and H1 A as minus U. So H1 P1 is minus H2 and K1 H1 is minus H2 plus H1. So we got this equation by considering the two similar triangles. Now let us consider another pair of similar triangles. So you have two triangles, H2P2F2, H2K2A'. So that is H2, P2 and F2. H2, P2, F2 and H2, K2, A'. So here you have this triangle which is similar to this triangle. So now let us write from the laws of similar triangles. So what we can write, P2 F2 divided by K2 A', which can be equal to P2 H2 that is divided by K2 H2. How? So P2 F2 here is this distance. So this distance divided by K2 A'. P2 F2 divided by K2 A', and P2 H2 divided by K2 H2. So we wrote this from the laws of similar triangles. Now let us understand. So P2 F2 is what? It is F2 divided by V, that is image distance, and which is equals to P2 H2. P2 H2 is the height of the object H1, that is in plus, and which is divided by K2 H2. We saw the K2 H2. K2 H2 is minus H2 plus H1. So we have another equation here. So let's suppose this equation be equation number 4 and this equation be equation number 5. So you have two equations, equation number 4 and equation number 5. Now let us see what will happen if we add these two equations, that is equation number 4 and equation number 5. By adding equation number 4 and 5, so the first equation number 4 is F1 divided by U, so the fifth equation is plus F2 by V. So this is equals to F1 by U had a value of minus H2 divided by minus H2 plus H1, and F2V had the value as plus H1 divided by minus H2 plus H1. So from this you can write F1 by U plus F2 divided by V is equals to minus H2 plus H1 divided by minus H2 plus H1. So if you add F1 by U plus F2 by V, then you will get minus H2 plus H1 divided by minus H2 plus H1. So these two terms will get cancelled. What remains is F1 divided by U plus F2 divided by V is equals to 1. So when this system or this optical system is situated in air, so both the part, image part and object part, both if they are in air, then we can write F2 is equals to minus F1, and let this equal be F. So because F1 is equals to minus F and F2 is equals to only F. So if you substitute this values in this equation, so what is F1? F1 is So if you substitute this 2 in this equation, so F1 is minus F divided by U plus F2 is only F, that is positive F divided by V, which is equals to 1. So now from this equation you can take F as common. So if you take F as common, what remains is 1 by U plus 1 by V, which is equals to 1. So you can write this equation as minus 1 by U plus 1 by V is equals to 1 divided by F. So this formula here is again similar to what the Lenz formula. So this is the final equation. This equation we got by considering two similar triangles in image side and two similar triangles in object side. So the triangles which we took in object side was F1, P1, K1 and K1, AH1. And in image side we took P2, F2, H2 and H2, K2, A prime. So by taking these two similar triangles in object side and two similar triangles in image side, we derived the formula minus 1 by U plus 1 by V is equals to 1 by F. So this derivation that we have derived in this class appears to be quite difficult, but if you are thorough with the diagram, or if you are clear with the ray diagram, then you can easily draw the diagram for the object which is placed on the principal axis, and from the diagram you can also understand where and how the image of this object which is placed on the principal axis is formed. So the image of this object AB is formed here, that is inverted. Because of that we took H1 is equals to minus H2. So this is inverted image. So object is here and the image of this object is here. So this we formed, or this we got by taking the intersection point of the three refracted rays that came out from the optical system, or by taking the emergent rays which came from the point A. So here all the rays are coming from point A and none of the rays are coming from the point B. So first ray which was parallel to the principal axis emerged out from the second focal point, and the second ray which came from the nodal point emerged out from the second nodal point, and the third ray which came out from the first focal point emerged out as a parallel to the principal axis in the image side. So these three rays, emergent rays, intersected here. So this intersected point forms the image of an object AB. So with the help of this diagram we derived the Newton's formula that said x1 x2 is equals to f1 and f2, and in continuation to that we also learned the Lenz formula minus 1 by u plus 1 by v is equals to 1 by f. So here v denotes the image distance, u is the object distance, and f is the focal distance. So hope this is clear. So in Newton's formula we found x1 which is multiplied by x2 will be equals to f1 multiplied by f2, and in other second derivation we found minus 1 by u is equals to 1 by f minus 1 by v. And in the first part of this lecture we understood how do we construct the image when an object is placed on the principal axis. So there are basically three points that you have to understand. So don't write the points directly like the way I am written. So you have to write the statement first, then from the diagram you have to say these points. So neat and clear diagram will help you to solve the problems. So try to understand how the incident ray falls on the principal axis and how the emergent rays comes out of the optical system. So if you understand these three points, then you can easily draw the image diagram for any object that is given.